It was probably around the end of 2006 and the beginning of 2007 that I finished writing The Lone Syndrome. I thought I'd make a simple movie with just three characters and get a few friends together and shoot it. Well, today's checklist for self-filming a short film. What I have here is a tripod. Since I'm going to be the actor also in the movie and shooting myself, I wanted to give the essence of a proper film.
It's difficult.
So I decided I'm going to try and create my own equipment.
So I'm going to devise a way where I can make this filming more interesting. So what I have here is a wheel that I'm going to try and fix on this tripod here, so we can have movement shots. Of course, without a cameraman, or the cameraman is me, and the actor is me too. So we'll see how we can figure this out. So here we go, trying to put this wheel on a tripod with a thread. We'll see where it goes. By the way, this is a trial, so I'm using a thread since I don't have anything else right now. Probably later in the day I'm gonna go get some ropes or something so I can tie this thing more securely, and it's a lot more safer.
I did manage to put a team together, but I could never get them together on the same day. And I got frustrated by the end, and I said,
will it work?
Screw that, I'm just gonna go out and make the movie myself with me in it, even if I have to shoot it through a remote control.
Ta-da!
Looks pretty impressive, I think. For a minute I thought I had it, I mean, and it sure does look I have got it. Oh, that's motor oil. You probably saw the bike in the movie, that's my bike, and I used to always have spare oil for the bike, so to make it smoother I got some oil in there. I don't know if it really worked or not, we'll see. So there, I'm trying to get a handle onto it so that I can, you know, move it with one hand and shoot myself for the scene that you'll see later. Up to this point it looked very impressive, like right now it looks perfect. I mean, I couldn't ask for better really. But I think the trouble really started when I mounted the camera on it, and the Canon XL one is not as light as we think it is, so I think once I got that on, it kind of, it really did not work to my advantage. I like this scene particularly because of the outlook it gave, like the passage and I did make a mistake in the perspective though, which you'll see probably later in the film, although I might try to flop it in edit and get it right. Like if you see I'm on the right side of the frame, and that's how it should go for the entire sequence, but somehow I went to the left side of the frame, which means I switched hands, and that's not right in filmmaking. There we go, I'm trying my motion shot, that is, and you can see how bad that rolling is. It's not really, it's kind of wobbling left, right, and whatever. So I try again, and I think every time I tried, it only got worse. There you can see the whole shot. I mean, I don't know if I got the shot. Well, actually, I did not. But I think at about this point, the wheel was almost out, and it almost took my camera off. So I stopped and just made use of whatever little I had. I think this was probably, well, it was not as difficult as it looks, but when you think about it, I think it came out pretty cool. Because what I'm trying to do is have me looking at the camera, and then behind me, a figure moves, and that has to be me. So there I was shooting my first frame of me sitting. Now I have to cheat the shot so that it looks like I'm still sitting there whilst I'm running in the background, which you'll see later. So I had this hat of mine kind of stuck to the chair. And then when I got that shot done and out with, I then shot the other part where I actually move in the background. And any filmmaker will know that I stuck these three shots together to make it look like one. I don't know if I thought of this before or it just came to me, I don't know, but I think it came out pretty cool in the movie. I love the shot, here you go. So there.
Okay, it's 7 p.m. right now, and I'm basically working on my script for tonight's filming. Tonight will be the third night in a row that I'll be filming. Somehow, I've been filming since like 10 at night till about 4:35 in the morning. It's been going on for the past 2 days, but it'll be the third night. This is what I make my notes on. I log my shots down for tonight's filming. These are my notes onto what the schedule is going to be like. I mean, that's scene 8, scene 7, you got 7 again with lines on it, and
that gel that you saw was just a regular gel from a craft shop, not really the gel that you use in movies. This is my hand trying to get the shot that I wanted of me in bed. So there I am using a remote control, which is pretty much my friend in the entire filming process. I mean, pretty much everything I shot with the help of a remote control. Now that's something that I really love, cookies. That's what I was doing earlier, cutting cookies. And those shadows on the side really give you some kind of a drama.
Absolutely, for cookies.